values, because in this solution we don't have any half integer values, but in our angular momentum calculation we came out that there is a possibility of the half integer value is, and to find out that how the half integer values came in there, we will have, there is a clue that there is something else inside as well, and that we call the span, and we call the span half or the span of this electron. So in order to find the details of these half integer values, we will have to wait till we discuss the span of an electron. So for the moment we will only stick to the angular momentum, and we will further find out the details in the angular momentum and different plottings that are associated with the orbital angular momentum. Now we will interpret what is meant by the orbital angular momentum, and for that we will take support from the classical mechanics as well, and the inside the magnetism as well. So this is quite strange that we came to know that the angular momentum L can have some quantized values. This is L is L into L plus 1 h bar. So the angular momentum, unlike classical mechanics, can have quantized values, while in classical mechanics we can have continuous values of the angular momentum. The other very startling thing that we came to know, that the number of these quantized value is also fixed, which is 2L plus 1. So an electron which is revolving in hydrogen atom can have some fixed values of the angular momentum, and the angular momentum itself is having quantization in it. So let's consider that we are having a nucleus. This is a nucleus, and we consider the classical picture of the hydrogen atom, and we are having an electron that goes around this nucleus. So we are having an electron which is going around this nucleus inside a hydrogen atom. We know that one quantization was put on the energy, which was the principal quantum number, and the orbits of the electrons were quantized. Now inside a given orbit, its angular momentum is quantized as well. Like for example, it can have this orbit, or it can have an orbit like this, or an orbit like this, or an orbit like this. So the other orbits, they are forbidden. The other orbitals inside this orbit, these are the orbitals, are the other orbitals are forbidden. Means like we can have the direction of the, if it is going this way, and this is the angular momentum direction. Similarly, if it goes this way, then this will be the angular momentum direction. And for this one, this will be the angular momentum direction. So the we can say that the directions of the angular momentum are quantized, or there are specific orbitals which are allowed, the other are not. So we will have to explain or interpret this thing, that how this is occurring. Now we will start with the means, these directions are given by the quantum number ml, which is giving the means ml h bar, and this is lz, means one of the component of the angular momentum. And this direction, the z direction, we have taken arbitrary or by our choice, that we will select a given axis, and with respect to that we will have to decide. Now this is not something physical, but we have in the space, we have selected one axis with the help of which we can say that what angle this will make, and what angle this will make, and what angle this will make. So this is our just like our reference frame, this is arbitrary, we can take any direction, but we have taken the z direction here. Now in order to understand this, we will have to use or take help of magnetism. Now this electron, it's a charged particle, and there is a fundamental charge on this particle which we call the electronic charge. And this tiny electron or tiny electronic charge, when it goes around, it is like a tiny current loop. So we will have to come to the magnetism, that when when current flows inside a wire, then it generates magnetic field. If this is the axis which is going through the wire, and current is going in this wire, then it will generate magnetic field, and that magnetic field will be such that it will be like this, means going around this loop. As it goes close to this axis, it flattens, and similarly here as well. So it flattens, it curves more when goes away, and finally we are having something like this. So this is a current loop, and this current is that when we increase current in this loop, the magnetic field will increase as well. And this current we are increasing, it is increasing the magnetic field here, and we call this loop of current is the magnetic dipole, the definition or the modern definition of a magnetic dipole. And if we go beyond this, for example this way or this way from this current loop, then the magnetic field lines will be more straightened, and like if we go more than the diameter of this loop, then it will behave like a bar magnet. And bar magnet, we know that it is having south and north poles, south and north poles, and the line starts from north and enters the south. So it is like this. This one is exactly a replica of this one, a permanent magnet which we call a bar magnet. So our electron is also like a current carrying wire, or we call that this is a tiny magnetic dipole. And now here, when we were increasing current, we were getting more magnetic field. Now here, for the electron dipole, when we will be increasing the orbital angular momentum, we will have more magnetic field. And as we are having the at atomic level, the fundamental quantity is the electronic charge, which is this, then at atomic level, the magnetic field, or the magnetic field due to this tiny electronic loop, we call that BM. That is also the fundamental quantity here, and we define the BM as the Bohr magneton. We call that tiny magnetism, or that tiny magnetic field, is the Bohr magneton, and this gives us the magnetic field mu is equal to L into L plus 1 times the Bohr magneton. So the more the value of L, the more will be the magnetism or the magnetic field by this. This is magnetic dipole moment. So we can have, we can utilize this magnetism or the magnetic property of this dipole in order to find out the nature of the orbital angular momentum. So we go like this, that when there will be these different loops will be there, and they will be means such an atom will be passing through a non-uniform magnetic field. In the absence of magnetic field, like now this atom is passing through a non-uniform magnetic field, non-uniform in the sense that like this, and this like a wedge shape. So in this region we will have a non-uniform magnetic field. When the field will be absent, then we will have on the detector a spot like this, that there will be no variation. But when the field will be present, then these magnetic dipole moments will, these dipoles will actually align themselves to this magnetic field, and we will have different spots here on the detector because their alignment will be different, and this will be the direct confirmation of the different orbital angular momenta that this electron is possessing. So what will happen, that when this will pass through this, then we will have spots like this, and let me exaggerate this one a bit more. So like here, like this is a line this is a line, and we are having the one spot here, like this is the first, this is the second, and this is the third here. Similarly, we are having one here and one here, and this is the line. So like this one, and now I will have to see this, that this is, let's say, or let's say we define it like this, that this is our south and this is our north pole. So our magnetic field is, this is north and this is south, so it's in this direction, and we just draw this line straight, and then to this line, let's say this is our line that I draw in order to plot the values correctly. Okay, right. So this point is here. This point is here. While this point is touching at this and here, this one is touching here and this one here. So what we will have, that the when there is no magnetic field, so we will have our spot here on the detector at this point, while the one, the alignment of these orbits will be either like this, or this will be, means this is this alignment, this is this value actually, and the other alignment is this one, or it will be something like this alignment and then this alignment. So our orbitals will actually align in this magnetic field like this. So this is the confirmation that there are quantized orbital angular momenta, and this is, let's say, the BM value. This will be then the